This is Edison Abelard, and in this video, we're going to discuss how to move objects in Unity 3D using force. Now, this is our simple scene that we set up, and all we have is literally a floor, a cube, and our first-person controller. Now, you'll notice when I click on the first-person controller, our camera is actually facing this way. So what we're going to do first is take our player, move him back, take our cube and move it forward, so when we start we'll see everything on the screen. Next, what we're going to do is create another game object, cube, and just lift it above the ground. Click play, and you'll notice our cube stays stationary. You can jump on this cube, turn around. Oh, not on the cube. But you'll notice that the cube never moves. And the cube I'm talking about is the one up here. It never moves. In order for objects to interact or move in 3D space, force has to be applied to it. In our case, we normally, in ActionScript, just plus X minus Y. That's normally how our world units work. But in 3D space, what we have to do is take that same concept of applying force and apply it to the actual object. So in our case, we're not going to do plus X plus Y, and instead we're going to add force using gravity. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to click on the object, click on component, go down to physics, and rigid body. We add rigid body and click play. You'll notice that our object now falls to the ground if we look at it. Now, what we can do is just duplicate it and create more of them so you can see how they all look and how they interact with each other. But first, before we do that, we're going to show you how one object that does have a rigid body attached to it and one that doesn't interact. Click play. And you'll notice that it falls to the ground. Moving a little too fast. We'll get a little closer. This is actually a little bit above the ground, so that's the reason why you had a little more fall. We can take another object, create another game object, and let's do a sphere. And you'll notice that the sphere has a sphere collider attached to it. We'll move this cube out the way, the one without the rigid body. Take this down a little closer. I'm going to guess it's going to fall to the left. Let's see if I'm correct. See if we can get a little double collision going. Fall. Oh, perfect. So that's how you apply force in 3D to an object.